Hi everyone, this is Venkatesh Panyam, your physics dude. I once again welcome you back to my channel. Today, in this video, we're going to learn some interesting applications of average velocity. Yeah, before I'll start the video or lecture, please subscribe my channel and share with your friends. And if you like my videos, please leave your comments. Welcome to the world of physics learning. Yes. Remember, what is average velocity? First of all, very simple formula. So everywhere we use the same formula. Average velocity means total displacement covered by total time taken. So we use the same formula everywhere. Even for average speed, total distance by total time. For average velocity, total displacement by total time. That is the only difference. Let's see the first problem. The problem number one. It's a very interesting problem. You all have seen this chasing of Jerry by Tom. In most of the cartoons, you have seen this. Now we would like to find out the average speed and the average velocity of Tom when he was chasing Jerry. What is the question? Let me explain the question first. Jerry started from the center of 10 concentric circular paths. There are 10 concentric circular paths, and the radius of each path is 1 meter, 2 meter, 3, 4, 5, like this, up to 10 meters. So the radius of the last circle is 10 meters. So Jerry started from the center of the first circle. He'll travel to the first circle. Let's call this as A. He'll complete one round around the circle, one revolution, then come to the point A, then he'll travel along this point, he'll go to the second circle B. He again completes one revolution around the second circle, he'll go to third circle. Like this, after completing a revolution on each circle, he'll enter into the 10th circle, again he'll complete one revolution, and by the time he was completely exhausted, now he is at rest after running. And then this Tom has to catch the Jerry who is resting after completing these revolutions 10 times. And since he was completely exhausted, he is taking rest. Knowing that the Tom slowly started doing the same process and you want to catch Jerry. Now the question is, what is the average speed and average velocity of Tom? So Tom also will do the same thing. He'll move from center of the first circle to the, circumference, then he'll complete one revolution there, the same way Jerry have done that. Let me answer this one. So let us calculate, what is the total distance covered by Tom? Total distance covered by Tom. So D is equal to, he'll complete one meter, from his radius is 1 meter, so 1 plus, what is the circumference of the first circle? 2 pi r, the radius is 1 meter plus. Again, he'll move from A to B, the radius of second circle is 2 meters, radius of first 1 meter, so it will be 1 meter again, 1 plus, again, 2 pi into the radius of the second circle is 2. So like this, he'll do the same thing up to 10. So again, I'll write at last 2 pi into 10. So what is the total distance? Let me calculate. So D is equal to, whenever he is moving from one circle to the other circle, he'll walk 1 meter. So 10 plus, in every circle take 2 pi common, I'll get 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on up to 10. So this is nothing but 10 plus 2 pi into 55. Okay. So if you simplify that, this is nothing but 10 plus 6.28 into 55, which is comes out to be around 355.4 meters. Yeah, one more thing we should know that, and all this Jerry completed in half an hour. Time is also given. Time is given as half an hour. For all this, he ran so fast, so he could complete all this in half an hour. And this Thomas has to run all this distance through half an hour only. Okay. Now let us find out his average speed now. So what is average speed? Average speed is nothing but total distance is 355.4. By time, half an hour means 30 minutes. So 30 into 60 seconds. So this value comes out to be 19.7 into 10 power minus 2. 19.7 into 10 power minus 2 meter per second. This is 19.7 into 10 power minus 2 meter per second. Okay. Let me check the answer once. Yes, 19.7 to 10 power, correct only. So this is the average speed of both Tom and Jerry because they have traveled the same distance in the same time. Now let us calculate what is meant by average velocity. Now what is the displacement? He started from the center, O let us take, and all the way he went to, this is the shortest path. So 1 meter every time. So the total displacement will be, and here let us calculate the total displacement. Total displacement of Tom will be 10 meters. So therefore, so average velocity is nothing but 10 upon, again the same time, 30 into 80, which is nothing but 1 by 180 meter per second. 1 by 180 meter per second, or if you want, you can write in decimals. That comes out to be 0.00, around 56 meter per second. So this is a very quite interesting problem. The only thing is we need to find out how this Tom is moving, and whatever the way the Jerry has moved, the Tom is also moving the same way, and we calculated both the distance and time. Now let's move on to the second problem. So here they're given that a body travels from the point A, this is the point A, to the point C as shown. It is moving from A to B and B to C. In T seconds, the time is also given. Yeah, time T is given as 15 minutes. Okay. As shown the figures, find the average speed and time. So average speed and velocity. Average speed and average velocity we need to find. So here D is given as 10 meter. Radius of this is also given as 10 meter. So let us simplify the first problem. Let's go to the first problem. And AB, what is the distance traveled? distance is nothing but the path length AB plus BC, nothing but 20 meter. 10 plus 10 is 20 meters. And therefore, what is the average speed? Average speed is nothing but 20 upon, what is the time given? 15 minutes. 20 by 15 into 60. So this will go by 3 times. So 1 by 45. So 1 divided by 45, which is around 0.02 meter per second. This is the average speed when you move from A to C. Now, what is the average velocity? For average velocity, we need to find out the shortest. So this is root 2 2d, because if d, d. So what is the displacement for this case? And displacement in this case, S is equal to root 2d, which is nothing but 1.414. Di gave it as 10. So nothing but 14.14 meters. Again, so what is the average velocity? 14.14, again 15 minutes into 60. So let's find out. 14.14 upon 15. Yeah, it is comes out to be 0.015 meter per second. Now coming to the second problem. In this case, the body, the path is a semicircle. So if you take a distance, distance is nothing but pi r, because it is moving like this. So it's a semicircle, so pi r. So 3.14 into what is the radius given? 10 meters. So nothing but 31.4 is the distance. And what is displacement? By the way, displacement of the shortest path is diameter. It is 2r, nothing but 20 meters. So for the second problem, let us calculate what is average speed. If I calculate the average speed for the second problem, so what is that we'll get? Let us see. So for the second problem, average speed is equal to, so what is the distance we got? Distance is 31.4. Distance is 31.4. Sorry. 31.4 by 15 minutes. Again, 15 to 60 only. So let me calculate the value. Which is around 0.034 meter per second. Now, what about average velocity? Displacement is, we got 20 meters, because the diameter is the what called as displacement. So you can find out for this problem, displacement is 20 meters. Then we can say that displacement by, again, 15 minutes, 15 into 60. So once again, this will go by 3 times, again 1 by 45. So 1 upon 45, so which is again 0.022 meter per second. So these problems are very simple problems. So only thing is, whenever you want to find out average velocity, average speed, only thing is we need to find out the total distance and total displacement, then you'll get the problem. Now look at the next problem. The question is, it is given like this. A boy is running You can see the picture. A boy is running along a circular path of radius r, some radius. Okay. If he completes one revolution in 40 seconds, then the ratio of magnitude of displacement and distance covered by him in 2 minutes 20 seconds, very important. So what is the total time? Total time is 2 minutes plus 20 seconds. That means 140 seconds. And he said that for every 40 seconds, he'll complete one round. One round means distance covered is 2 pi r. So 140 seconds means what? 3 rounds. And then again, half a round. He'll complete here. Then again, he'll complete half a round. Because this we can write 140 seconds, nothing but 3 into 40 plus 20. In 40 seconds, he'll complete 2 pi r. So what is the total distance covered? 3 into 2 pi r. Because for after every 40 seconds, he'll complete one round plus. Again, he'll move for 20 seconds, half the circle, that is pi r. This is pi r, nothing but 7 pi r. Let us don't substitute, we'll leave it like this then. What is the displacement in this case? Displacement will be the diameter. Why? Because he started from the point A, let us take, and finally is at B. So displacement is 2R. He's asking the value of R, S by D. What is S? 2R. What is D? We got 7 pi R. So we can say that this R cancel. So 2 upon 7 into what is pi value? 22 by 7. So if I cancel 7 upon 7, 2 1s, 2 11s. So ultimately the answer is 1:11. So which is the correct option? 1:11 is the C. C is the correct option. So we know that this boy is running in anti-clockwise direction. So clockwise only this is. In clockwise direction. And after every 40 seconds, he'll complete one round. So in 140 seconds, he'll complete 3.5 rounds. For 3 rounds, 3 into 2 pi r, half round is pi r, so 7 pi r. Let's move on to the next problem. This is a very simple problem. A particle moves along x-axis with a speed 6 meter per second for the first half of the distance of a journey and the second half distance velocity. So very, very simple. We know that when the displacements are equal, this is V1, this is V2, the expression for average velocity is 2V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. So 2 times, what is V1 given? V1 is given as 6, V2 given as 3. So 6 into 3 by 6 plus 3. So this is nothing but 18 by, so this is I think 4 meter per second. This will be 4 meter per second. So the right option is third option. It's a direct formula based question. Now let's move on to the next problem. So what is this question is all about? Yeah, since a girl is walking along a straight road for the first t by 3 seconds time with a speed V1, and for the next 2t by 3 time with a speed, sorry, this is V2, with a speed V2. Then the mean speed and average speed both are same. Mean speed of the girl for the complete journey is, she is walking. Now let me show the picture. This girl is walking on the road, the straight road, remember, and she is walking with a speed V1 for t by 3 time. After this t by 3 time, she changed her velocity to V2 and she walked for 2t by 3 time. Now we need to find out what is the average velocity. So we know that average velocity is equal to V1 T1 plus V2 T2 by T1 plus T2. When times are given, this is the expression for average. Look at total displacement by total time. Displacement is velocity into time. That's what I applied. So if I write, so what is a V1? V1 is V1 only. Sorry. So V1 into T by 3 plus V2 into 2T by 3 whole upon T by 3 plus 2T by 3. So if we simplify this, so I think you'll get cancel all these things. So simply this will become V1 plus 2V2 whole upon 3 will be there. No? Yeah, 3 will be there. Yes. V1 plus 2V2 by 3. Let us see the options. V1 plus 2V2 by 3. Yeah, the answer is first option. So very, very simple formula based question. This is again. So when she's covering some time with velocity V1, some other time with velocity V2. So in terms of time, this is the average velocity. Yeah, we discussed all these formulas in the previous lecture. Now let us see another important model. A man covers, it is opposite to that problem. A man covers 2/5 of the total distance with a velocity V1. This man is walking with velocity V1 for 2/5 of displacement. And he changed his speed after that. And he started moving with the velocity V2. And the remaining, what is the displacement? 3/5 of S. Now he's asking, what is the average velocity? When the displacements are given, what is the average velocity formula in terms of displacements? Right, let me write the equation. So the same procedure everywhere we need to find out. So average velocity is total displacement by total time. But time is not given. So we know that time is equal to displacement by velocity. So what is T1? 2 by 5. 2 by 5. S by. Yeah, V1. And what is T2? 3 S by 5 V2. Okay. This is 2S by 5V1. And this is 3S by 5V2. And by the way, what is the total displacement? Total displacement, let me calculate. The total displacement S1 plus S2 is 2 by 5S plus 3 by 5S, nothing but S only. Now let's substitute the total displacement we got, total time we got. So let us write that. So V average is equal to S upon, what is T1? 2 S by 3V1 plus 3 S by 5V2, right? So 2S by 5V1, sorry, this is 5V1. I'm sorry, here this is, this is 2S by 5V1 and this is 3S by, so what I can take common? S by 5 I can take common. So if I take S by 5 common, S upon, if I take S by 5 common, I have 2 by V1 plus 3 by V2. So this S, S cancel. If I write the answer, final answer, 5 V1 V2 by 2 V2 plus 3 V1. If you take LCM, so V1, V2 will go up. 5 valves will go up. So 5 V1, V2 by 2 V2 plus 3 V1 by, I mean 5 V1, V2 into 2 V2 plus 3 V1. So it is again a tired formula based. So we need to calculate what is the total displacement and what is the total time. Then you can simplify this problem. Now let's see one more problem. This is also another interesting problem. So it seems a boy reaches his school by walk in 1.5 hours. And where is school? It is at 4 kilometers away from his home. See, this is his home, and from here to here, how much? 4 kilometers. He is walking 4 kilometers. Yeah, how much time is taken for it? Here, the time taken is 1.5 hours. Okay. Then he was there in school. He was there here for 8 hours, from morning to evening. Was just there. So what happens? See. He will go to his friend's house. Okay, after that, he'll go to his friend's house, which is at a distance of 3 kilometers from the school. So sorry, there is a double O. Yeah, he'll go to his friend's house, which is at a distance of 3 kilometers. See, it is exactly along the straight line only. It is given as 3 kilometers, as shown the figure, by walk in 1 hour. So here, what is the time taken? 1 hour. After spending 0.5 half an hour, he was there at the friend's house. Here he spent nearly 0.5 hours. Okay. Then what he said? What he did? After spending half an hour, he said that with his friend, he reaches his home along the shortest path. Find his average velocity and average speed is asking. Now let us find out. What is the shortest path? This is the only shortest path. If this is 4 kilometers, this is 3 kilometers, since it is a right angle triangle, so we can say that the value of this will be 5 kilometers. This is 5 kilometers. Now let us calculate the total distance covered and total time taken. So what is the total distance covered by the boy? Let us calculate. So he total distance covered by the boy. Covered by the boy. D is equal to, see, 4 kilometers, 4 kilometers from his home to school. So then 3 kilometers from school to his friend's house. So this is 4 plus 3 plus again 5. So total he covered 12 kilometers. This is his distance. He started at home. Then he went to school. Then he went to his friend's house, which is 3 kilometers. Then again, he walked along this path, which is 5. So what is his average speed? So average speed is equal to total distance is 12 kilometers by it. What is the, yeah, before that, let us calculate what is the total time. Very, very important. So what is the total time for which he walked? See, 1.5 hours in coming from home to school, but we should not consider this 8 hours because he was at rest only. And even you don't consider this 0.5 hours, he was at rest. Only we need to consider the time taken from here to here. Yeah. And one more. So this is given as half an hour. Sorry, one more time is missing. Let us take this as 0.5 hours. Yeah, this is also must be given. So this is also given as from here to here, the time is given as 0.5 hours. He spent half an hour at his friend's home, and he took only half an hour to reach what to call it as no, 1.5 hour, 2.5. Yeah, let us take half an hour, no problem. So remember, maybe he's walking fast. Some people may argue that, sir, he took 1.5 hour, 4 kilometers then. Why? Because he was already late. He went to his friend's house. So definitely, he may be walking fast. So 1.5 hours plus 1 hour plus 0.5 hour. 0.5 hours is from friend's house to his house. So this is total 3 hours. So what is average speed? Average speed is total distance by total time, nothing but 4 kilometers per hour. his average is 4 kilometers per hour. Now, what is the average displacement we want to find out? What is the displacement? Displacement is the shortest distance between starting and ending point. So here we need to find out average velocity. Average velocity is equal to total distance is 5 kilometers, but again the total time is 3 hours, because 1.5 hours from school, I mean his from home to school, 1 hour from school to his friend's house, and again 0.5. So total time he took is, so this is around 1.6, okay, kilometers per hour. So in all these problems, the single most concept is only one. So the average velocity. So what is average velocity? Total displacement by total time taken. All these problems are based on the same concept, that is average velocity. So thank you. Thanks for listening. Yeah, again, I'm telling you, if you like my videos, please share with your friends and please comment below the video. And do not forget to click the bell icon for more updates. And we'll discuss some more topics in the next video. I wish you happy physics learning. Once again, thank you. Thanks so much.